morning. You're welcome to another edition of Import Export Platform Facebook Live from Great Impact Trade Academy. And I'll continue from where we stopped yesterday. And we're discussing packaging. Packaging. When you're shipping overseas, you must be aware of packing, labeling, documentation, and insurance requirements and regulation. And make sure that the merchandise is packed correctly so that it will arrive in good condition. Ensure that it's labeled correctly to ensure that the goods are handled properly and arrive on time at the right place. Also ensure that the merchandise is documented correctly to oversee government requirements as well as proper collection standard. Also ensure that the good is insured against damage, loss, pilferage, and delay. Still talking about packaging, number one, the good is packed correctly to arrive in good condition. I don't know if I've told you about this story in this series of someone who was importing okoroko. You know okoroko? Okoroko is stockfish. Was bought okoroko from, I think from Norway to Nigeria. And upon arrival, they opened the container and discovered that the content is already decaying, smelling. Why? While the goods was in transit, I guess there was tempest that made water to splash against the container, and some of those water seep into, because the container also probably was not watertight, seep into the container, the content, and touch the carton. And because the content is perishable, even though it was dry, but not perishable, the water penetrates the carton, touches the content, which is the product, and eventually decay started. And by the time it got to Nigeria and they were opening it, it was fully decayed. And that's not a good one, not a good one at all. Not a good one in the sense that whoever it is that packaged the goods fail to realize the fact that if you are exporting an item that is perishable, you don't need a prophet or prophetess to tell you that you should use a waterproof carton. So, and that's what they fail to do, to use a waterproof carton. And inability to use a waterproof carton was not what spelled doom for that transaction. But what spelled doom for that transaction. So what I'm basically trying to say is the fact that you need to ensure that the good you are exporting is well packaged. If it's a perishable item, it's packaged in such a way that the you won't have a situation in which there will be losses as a result of inadequate packaging, which could have been avoided if the item was well packaged, Now, packaging also helps with labeling. Because with packaging, you can then do a good labeling on the body of packaging. Remember, packaging is supposed to communicate. Packaging is supposed to communicate the detail of the item being shipped. So that when buyer wants to buy, it's easy for them to take an informed decision based on what they are seeing. When they want to buy, it's easier for them to take informed decision based on what they are seeing. This is very important, and this is very, very, very crucial. This is very important, and this is very, very, very crucial for good to be well packaged. One of the things we're going to do in the course of this program is to also show you how best you have to package your product. Sorry, you have to label your package, especially the many countries are very strict on food related items because people will have to eat that. Many people are very strict on food related items because people will have to eat that. So you need to know exactly how best to package your product in order to ensure that at the end of the day, you do not sell product to the public that will make the public to be that will make the public to be eating poison. And you don't want to see yourself paying fine. Because, I mean, if you have a good relation with the buyer and the buyer have to pay fine because of the quality of what you ship to him, he will transfer it to you. Now, if you fail to reimburse him, you can likewise kiss that relationship goodbye. Especially because in the environment and the client when they operate, they do not joke. They do not joke with the life of their citizen. So if the citizenry are having issue with the quality of the item, they will report. Even if they are not having issue with it, and it's not been detected, the fact that the agency of government come from time to time to see what exactly you are selling, to assess what exactly you are selling, and to be sure of the quality of what you are selling to their citizen, can make them to detect any infringement in the quality of the item they are selling to their populace. And this is very important for some countries. Why? Because unlike a lot of African countries, some of these countries do not joke with the health of their citizens. Some of these countries do not joke with the health of their citizens. So that's why if you are doing food-related products, it becomes extremely, extremely important for you to really know what you are doing. It becomes extremely, extremely important for you to really know what you are doing. It becomes extremely, extremely important for you to really know what you are doing. Meaning, nasty mistakes, costly mistake will not be tolerated. Nasty mistake, costly mistake will not be tolerated. Because of the multitude of considerations involved in physically exporting goods, exporters often receive assistance from their air carrier or freight forwarder to perform those services. The service of insurance, the service of documentation are performed by forwarders. But I'm of the opinion that maybe because of Nigeria environment, you should not leave the lifeline of your business in the life of a third party who has nothing to lose if the transaction go bad. You should rather undo the area of the shipment that you can do yourself and follow up on the agent, the forwarding agent, to do the one they to do. Don't leave the lifeline of your business in the hand of a stranger, of a third party, of a forwarder who has no stake if eventually the transaction has issue and goes bad. Ensure you carry as much as you can and let them do what they are meant to do. Do not, as much as possible, do not leave the lifeline of your business in the hand of a stranger. Do not leave the lifeline of your business in the hand of someone who do not have a stake. What do I mean by someone who do not have a stake? I mean someone that if anything happened, he does not have anything to lose. If anything happened, he does not have anything to lose. So what do you do? Be in charge of your transaction. Basically, that's what I'm basically telling you. You should be in the driver's seat of your transaction. Engage a forwarder to do what they should do. You should do what you should do. Engage a forwarder to do what they should do. And you should do what you have to do. Why am I saying this? If you don't do what you have to do, and you left everything in the hand of these other people, the challenge you will have is you will lose everything and pay the cost of everything if everything or anything go wrong on that transaction. So knowing fully well that if anything goes wrong on this transaction, you will bear the cost of the losses. My opinion, why don't you then allow them to do what they have to do, while you also go ahead to do what you have to do? Why then do you want to leave the lifeline of your business in the land, in the hand rather, of a stranger? And I call them a stranger in the sense that when there are issues bordering on this transaction, they are not going to be held responsible. Your buyer abroad is going to have to deal with you when things go wrong with your transaction. So what do you want to do? You want to ensure that at no point are you leaving the lifeline of your own business in the hand of a stranger. At no point are you leaving the lifeline of your own business in the hand of a stranger. I'm emphasizing this seriously because of what I've seen. I'm emphasizing this seriously because of what I have seen, the way people leave the lifeline of their business in the hand of a forwarder who will process their pre-export documentation, pay their next fee, process their post-export documentation, literally have the lifeline of that business in their hands, such that if anything goes wrong, they have nothing to lose. For those that have lost money, have delays, have issues, as a result of inefficiency of forwarder, they will not leave their business in the hand of a forwarder. As an expert, you have limitation on what you can handle. As an exporter, you have limitation on what you can handle. Understandably so, because the regulation require that a custom license agent is the person that can clear the goods. As a result of this, you will not be able to do everything as far as the shipment is concerned. That is okay. They are not able to do everything. It's very okay. What you then should do is, the one you have the power to do, the one you have the right to do, the one you have all it takes to do, should not be left in the hand of a stranger. If you do so, I can assure you, you will have yourself to blame. If you do so, I can assure you, you will have yourself to blame. Why? Many people in the past have left the lifeline of their business in the hand of a stranger. And you know what? They have themselves to blame. They have themselves to blame. You know? They have themselves to blame. Why? Because the person they gave their transaction to do to undo had other interests and messed up the transaction. Like I said, when you mess up the transaction, you bear the brunt. When you mess up the transaction, you bear the brunt. Please, I'm emphasizing this and I'm saying it, at least for Nigeria, I don't know of other country, don't leave the lifeline of your business in the hand of a stranger. Do not leave the lifeline of your business. By lifeline of your business, I mean critical things to the success of your transaction. I mean things that has to do with shipment on time and in time. And like I said, you don't need the agent to handle a lot of things for you. There are things they can handle because you can handle it. By regulation. You cannot handle it by regulation. Why? The agency of government license. The agency of government that they will interface in the course of export only license a few people to undo that. So they don't want to be dealing with every importer. Let a few people undo that on behalf of the customer, which is okay. Only that if you allow them to undo for you everything beside what the regulation allow them to do, you have yourself to blame. So what should the forwarder undo for you? Export clearing. You do your processing of pre-export documentation. Fill the NSP form, submit it, pay your next fee, give them a copy of the document so they can go to the port and do the clearing with customs. Do your booking of your container yourself. Do your booking of your shipment yourself. Pay to the shipping line yourself. Do all relation with shipping line yourself. Let them just undo. Even in booking truck, book the truck yourself. Just tell them this is the person that is carrying it. You follow up with them. Do not leave the lifeline of your business in the hand of a stranger. Do not leave the lifeline of your business in the hand of a stranger. According to Wikipedia, packaging is a technology of enclosing or protecting products for distribution, storage, sales, and use. The technology of enclosing, technology of protecting, technology of closing and protecting product for distribution, protecting product for storage, enclosing and protecting product for sales and for use. Packaging also refers to the process of design, process of evaluation, and production of packaging. Process of design, process